Doug Anderson and welcome to the Sault, the unofficial gateway to northwestern Ontario, the place of the rapids, an appropriate spot for the June 2016 PCM, as Ona is facing choppy waters, but we are definitely not just treading water. President Linda Haslam Stroud launched the PCM protesting unsafe staffing levels.
The CIHI report, the Canadian Institute of Health Information, just was released last week. And unfortunately, Ontario has moved up in the ranks. Up in the ranks mean we unfortunately have the dubious distinction of having the worst, not second to worst, but the worst nurse to patient ratio in the country for RNs. We are no longer second to BC. Shame is right. And you know what? I have never been so disgusted to be number one in anything in my life.
These two RNs took their fight for safer staffing to an independent assessment committee that produced 91 unprecedented recommendations. It was a fight that touched them deeply.
I did basically everything that I felt I could do for the patient. She had multiple comorbidities, but she was ultimately diagnosed with pneumonia. And given her level of acuity, she would actually be in our hospital, she'd be very appropriate for an ICU level care. I spoke to my supervisors, spoke to the physician, and there was a huge delay in accessing or be able to go over to the ICU. And I was a 1-to-5 nurse patient ratio. And like I said, she would be like a 1-to-1, 1-to-2 absolute max.
There was so many times that I wouldn't take breaks. I would go days on days working without a meal break because I wanted to support coworkers. And then my family suffered because I would come home emotionally drained and physically exhausted. That's what made me want to fight the fight and make our hospital, our employer, recognize that we were working in conditions that were not favorable to our patients or to our staff and that they had to make the change.
CEO Marie Kelly urged leaders to refocus the conversation on skill mix.
We're hearing a lot about skill mix change. In fact, it's a concept that's been created by the government to have a conversation with Ontarians about the direction they want to go in, which is less money into healthcare, less quality care, less people with high level of skills who are being paid an appropriate rate of pay for the work that they do for the people of Ontario. They've created that terminology and applied it to healthcare and to RNs in a way that has changed the conversation about healthcare. We've got to turn that dial and change the conversation back to what Ontarians know and want, which is we want to talk about our healthcare. Who is the most appropriate person to provide the service that's needed in varying situations, depending upon acuity, depending upon the patient, et cetera, et cetera. We need to teach Ontarians to look behind the verbiage that's being used, skill mix, de-skilling, and to have the conversation about what they want for their families and for themselves.
Marie encouraged leaders to broaden their activism into the Sault community, lending a helping hand for an afternoon to 4 community projects. We also reflected on our victory at Health Sciences North, where 3 women convinced workers to be courageous. Courageous enough to put their livelihoods on the line and join ONA.
We're on the ship that we've been waiting for forever. Yeah, we know what ship drives our hospital, and we're finally on it. Yay.
Woohoo!
Finally, we debated potential changes to our constitution that could happen at the biennial convention.
I'm just going to ask for a quick show of hands on this one. So we'll have more discussion about that as we move forward to November.
And the PCM ended with a countdown to the biennial convention. This is Doug Anderson for PCM Précis.